everyone. Narcissist Free Almost here, and today I wanted to talk about the frequency of narcissism. So put on your esoteric hats and enjoy the ride. Most of us here tend to agree that the rise in awareness of narcissism is akin to a spiritual battle of good versus evil. This is something I give a lot of thought to and start to wonder, are narcissists fully human? Anyone who's ever been with a full-blown pathological narcissist probably gives this some thought as well. We're starting to realize that the people and institutions we've trusted to have our best interests at heart are, in fact, stabbing us in the back, using that trust and our empathy against us to do us harm. These people, if you can call them that, for example, see trust as a weakness. But I trusted you, you say to the abuser, only to have them smirk and retort,
"Well, you shouldn't have."
As they slink off with your valuable time, treasure, and trust, essentially blaming you for what they have done. And more often than not, there is no recourse. They just got away with it, again. That said, I'm one that entertains so-called conspiracy theories. I say so-called only because, as of late, many are turning out to be true, so they don't seem to be that far-fetched any longer. Just had to add that in my defense. Nevertheless, I like to listen to David Icke and his theories and research on psychopathy. Psychopathy, you say? What do lizards and fake moons have to do with psychopaths? Crazy, you say? Perhaps, but what if he's onto something? David Icke often talks about something named Wetiko. An evil spirit of sorts from Native American mythology portraying the mythical figure of Wetiko as a cannibalistic spirit who embodies greed and excess and will possess humans. The Wetiko was once a human being, but its greed and selfishness transformed it into a much feared predatory monster. In this indigenous mythology, indulgent and self-destructive habits are thought to be inspired by Wetiko. Those who have become Wetikos are individuals who have lost their mind without thinking anything's wrong with them. Wetiko is often described as having a frigid, icy heart, devoid of mercy, and like cannibals, those taken over by Wetiko consume the life force of others for their own purposes or profit, and do so without giving back anything of real value. They are the ultimate exploiters and takers. Essentially, it can be thought of as a mind virus, and it can only survive and thrive at low frequencies. So it has to infect its host and keep them in a low frequency state in order to continue using them and feeding. Going a little further down the rabbit hole, some would say that certain types of people are born with a DNA sequence that only allows them to survive in low vibrational states. In other words, some are Wetiko, and some are infected by Wetiko. They would be considered expressions of evil, which simply means anti-life. For example, they abhor truth, evidenced by their pathological lying. They are unable to love, or have any capacity for empathy, and think nothing of stealing or appropriating someone else's property. They have no identity of their own. In fact, they have to mimic and purloin others' character traits to pass themselves off as normal, or to get what they want. Doesn't sound too human to me? So you have some that are born low vibration and some that are infected, and anyone who's been with a narcissist for too long knows that, not only are you brought to the lowest points in your life by the hand of the narcissist, but you start to behave like them as well, as if you've been infected. Taking a look at the map of consciousness by David Hawkins, you can plainly see where the narcissists live, in the destructive energy. And chances are really good the narcissist met you when you were living high in your creative energy, at least that's how it was for me. The energy vampires that they are were literally sucking the life out of you by absconding your high frequency states. The shift to abuse happens when you are starting to fall down the frequency scale. They notice this, in fact they cause it. So the greedy buggers that they are now have to feed on your low frequencies, which obviously are not as potent. To enhance the energy they need, they do everything they can to keep you down, and make it worse. They will feed until you are no longer of any use to them, then move on to the next victim. On top of that, to further reinforce the DNA theory, ask any psychopath and they will refer to themselves as a superior species, separate from the common masses. Others, such as Dr. George Simon, if they had their way, would classify these people as a subspecies of human. I would tend to agree. Furthermore, David Icke describes an ancient bloodline whose DNA sequence sentences them to a low vibrational state. So in order to feed, they must keep their host at the same low vibrational state. The more pain and suffering there is, the tastier their meals and the greater chances for their survival. David Icke describes these creatures' characteristics as having no remorse, no empathy, no shame, parasites, pathological liars, Machiavellian. In other words, they are what we presently refer to as psychopaths. Could Mr. Icke have traced the roots of psychopathy as a DNA sequence all the way back to the beginning of civilization? And the reason we're only finding out about it now is because the psychopaths at the top have deliberately remained hidden for centuries? That is something a psychopath would do, that's for sure. They're all about staying hidden, allowing them to remain efficient predators. This would also explain all the secret societies and secret agendas of governments coming to the fore as awareness is expanding. Given those ingredients, what do you think? Is this a spiritual battle? Would Tycho en masse? A secret ancient bloodline making its way into the general population and corrupting normal human beings. Are we awakening from being deliberately kept at low frequencies, such as constant fear pumped out by politicians? Are these personalities using chaos and mayhem to feed as well as distract while they steal from us? It all seems plausible in this day and age, and by that I mean, the world seems to have gone mad. I don't think there's anyone who can say we are living in anything resembling normal times. Finally, it seems that all cultures across history have described the exact same phenomenon. There is Islam and the Jinn, Christians who have their demons, and the Zulu have the Chotahari. Each and every one of these are evil spirits whose purpose is to infect human beings, causing as much suffering as possible. They do this because human beings are special and they envy us. We're able to create, love, and experience joy, something they will never be able to do. For that we must be brought down to their disgusting level, corrupting all things beautiful. Think of that the next time you hear about drag queen story time, or transhumanism. Believing that this is progress is the black magic spell cast to destroy us and everything good about us. Family, your religious beliefs, and freedom are what they really want, and the only remedy for such evil is a choice between fear and love. Choose wisely.